Welcome to ISC Markets. You are watching weekly market overview by ISC Markets. Let's start. The US dollar was again the best performer against the world's major currencies, confidently strengthening against all competitors for the second week in a row. The biggest loss of 2.8% was shown by the Australian dollar this time. Other major currencies showed rather synchronous decline, losing from 1.1% to 1.7%. The Australian dollar continued to fall after the nation's central bank reduced the key overnight rate to a historically low value of 2.75%. In full accordance with our expectations, last week the currency dropped again at the US dollar to 0.97, which will now play a key support role. Let us also note the decline of the euro below previously indicated support at 1.2950. Now the pair is moving towards the 2013 low at 1.2750. But the worst technical picture for the euro will develop in case of a fall below an 8-month low of 1.27660, with a target level below 1.20. Though it is still early to speak about such a scenario with confidence, the macroeconomic prerequisites exist for it as well. We expect the rate of the single currency to drop in the medium term. The British pound fell last week below a key short-term support 1.52 designated by us, and is trading now not too far. Sell signals dominate. Thus, the pair does not took oversold, and we prefer short positions on pound dollar. The dollar yen keeps on moving higher after overcoming resistance at 100 yen per dollar. Our short-term goal is at around 104, where the estimated triangle chart pattern target is placed. In terms of macro statistics, let us pay attention to this week's publication of the minutes of the May meeting of the Reserve Bank of Australia on Tuesday. We are waiting for the explanation of the reasons for rate reduction and comments on future actions of the bank. The same day, the numbers on April's inflation will be released in the UK. We are expecting a reduction of inflationary pressure, opening room for the Bank of England to act, and this is a negative factor for the pound. On Wednesday, the meeting of the Bank of Japan will take place. The minutes of the last meeting of the Bank of England and later in the evening minutes of the main meeting of the Fed will be published. In addition, on Wednesday, the Fed Chairman Ben Bernanke will deliver a speech on economic outlook. Each time, this is a potential chance to hear how close the regulator is to curtail the program of quantitative easing. On Thursday, we are waiting for the May preliminary data on manufacturing activity in the Eurozone and the UK's GDP in the first quarter. Finally, on Friday, a lot of statistics will come from Germany, including an updated GDP and indices of consumer and business expectations, plus the April orders for the durable goods in the United States. Finally, let us turn to the indicators of market sentiment. Judging from the latest figures of Commodity Futures Trading Commission, the changes in the positioning of futures market participants on speculative transactions took place mainly in favor of the US dollar. Net short positions rose on all major currencies, except the Canadian dollar. The biggest changes have taken place in the positioning of the euro and the Australian dollar. The latter ceased to be the only currency among the six majors possessing net long position against the US dollar, joining a list of currencies with net short positions. Overall positioning confirms our expectations regarding the dynamics of the major currency pairs. You are watching a weekly market overview by ISC Markets. Do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us every Tuesday. Bye!